The USS Congressional Research Service report on terrorism is out, and it has confirmed and solidified the fact the world already knows that Pakistan is a safe haven of terrorists. The report reveals that Pakistan is home to at least 12 groups designated as foreign terrorist organizations. These also include 5 terror organizations like Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed, which target India. Many of these 12 terrorist groups target countries like the US with majority Christian and Jewish populations. Some extremist groups are Kashmir-oriented. The US, which is immensely irked and frustrated with Pakistan's lambasting on its handling of the Afghanistan crisis, is likely to take a strict action against the country. Both the US President Joe Biden and US Vice President Kamala Harris discussed terrorism in Pakistan with Indian Prime Minister Modi in their one-to-one bilateral meeting with the leader. The Taliban episode has ended Pak's game of playing victims of terrorism. Such open criticism from the US, which is also a major funding source for the downtrodden Pak economy, indicates a likely strict stance of the US this time. Ahead of the UNGA summit, Antony Blinken, USS Secretary of State, too had said ties with Pakistan will be revisited. Pakistan's ties with the Haqqani network, their open support of Taliban militants, their sheltering of Osama bin Laden, 20 years of feeding millions of American taxpayers' dollars to Pakistan for nothing has infuriated the United States. Will the US take a strict stance against Pakistan? Will the FATF blacklist Pakistan? Will the United Nations, World Trade Organization, and European Union impose sanctions on Pakistan?